Desperate mom calls 911 with a strange request for responding officers. The police dispatchers stationed in Lone Peak, Utah didn't receive a ton of frantic phone calls in the middle of the night. The mountain town was a quiet place. Late one winter evening, however, Shannon Bird phoned the department with desperation in her voice. She had a serious issue on her hands, and it was one that none of the officers had encountered before. Shannon and Dallin Bird were happy in Utah. Not only were they right outside Salt Lake City, one of the country's most scenic cities, but they lived right in the middle of the wilderness. For them, this had a lot of perks. Making a home in the thick of the gorgeous Utah nature meant the family frequently took camping trips and went on hikes. Soon, Shannon and Dallin grew comfortable taking their four kids just about anywhere. They could handle anything that came up. The mother chronicled her family trips, yes, even trips to the grocery store, on social media, and built up a little bit of a following. Around town, she was a recognizable face, which is why everyone was particularly excited in the winter of 2019. The happy couple welcomed a fifth addition to the family. Their daughter London soon stole the show on Shannon's Instagram, and the mother of five now had an even bigger reason to flaunt her happy family. But life had just become a little more hectic. As any parent knows, kids are prone to accidents. And only 2 months after London entered the world, Shannon's son Brooklyn severely injured his shin while playing outside. But Shannon was ready to take on the challenge. Brooklyn, who was too young to firmly grasp the skills needed to navigate the world on crutches, required constant supervision from Shannon. This wasn't a problem at first, but one night all the stress came crashing down in the worst way. Dallin was away on business in Las Vegas, which meant Shannon was left on her own devices with five kids. Everything was going fine until around midnight on January 29th, 2020, when London started crying. Shannon knew her daughter likely needed nursing, but there was one massive problem. She couldn't seem to produce any milk. Worse, there was no formula in the house, which instantly sent her into panic mode. Even in the great outdoors, Shannon had never experienced this dilemma with any of her other children. Even though it was after midnight, she began calling neighbors, desperate for one of them to pick up. However, every call went to voicemail. The rest of Shannon's kids were asleep, and she didn't want to wake everyone up, gather them into the car, and head out to the store at such a late hour. Concerned, she called Dallin to tell him the situation. Dallin was vital in calming her down, assuring her there was an outlet to help, the police. Shannon, however, didn't like the idea. Police didn't do grocery store runs in the middle of the night. He urged her to call anyway. So, Shannon was nervous the dispatcher she spoke with would shame her for calling 911 about a lack of milk in her home. However, she was greeted with an understanding voice who assured her they'd send help. The officers on duty at the time came up with a game plan. They needed to get Shannon's child's milk, and the correct kind, as soon as possible. So they contacted an officer named Brett Wagstaff. Over the course of his career, Wagstaff saw his fair share of odd requests, but this was the first time he heard of a mother in need of milk. He had a young daughter of his own, so he knew exactly where to go. With a quick trip inside a convenience store, he bought a gallon of milk and headed straight to Shannon's home. The mother was ecstatic to see him, but soon her enthusiasm drained a little. The milk he'd picked up was too harsh to give to an infant. Determined to do his duty, Wagstaff left the milk with the mother and drove straight to Walmart, which miraculously was still open. This time, armed with more proper information, he picked out another formula to bring to Shannon. When he finally returned, he assured Shannon of his purchase. "That's the same stuff we gave my daughter when she was first born, so hopefully it doesn't upset her stomach," he said. Shannon breathed a huge sigh of relief as London drank the formula. It was a night neither she nor the police department would ever forget. From that point forward, Shannon kept a stockpile of formula on hand, just in case. It's always nerve-wracking on both ends, for parents and police officers when an incident with a young child occurs. Luckily, police are prepared to handle any situation thrown their way, no matter how stressful it is.